Hello YouTube and welcome back to the channel. Today I'm taking a look at this 2021 Ford Expedition. This particular one is pretty special because it is an XLT trim, but it does have the ultimate package, so it's very loaded for being essentially the base trim Expedition. The exterior color is antimatter blue with a black leather interior, I believe, and it has a 3.5 liter EcoBoost V6 and a 10-speed automatic transmission. This does have the chrome package as well, as you can see with the grille. Halogen headlights, and I believe those are LED fog lights. Tow recovery hooks in the front portion of the bumper. Very aggressive looking. This actually is the last year you can get this particular style, because for 2022, they did slightly refresh the front end as well as the taillights, and then the interior slightly changed. Coming to the wheel and tire setup, it looks like we have some Dana Pro ATMs, and they're 275/55R20. Chrome running boards, and they're actually pretty wide too. Typically, Ford in the past has had some real thin running boards, and these are very, very nice and wide. Color matched mirror caps, cargo rack up top. Your incandescent taillights, and I believe your blind spot monitor is in there or below as well. Parking sensors for the rear are going to be integrated into the bottom portion of the bumper. Your hitch is going to be right behind this plastic piece. You got your XLT badge right over here. Expedition is stamped into this chrome portion. Your backup camera is going to be right there. This glass does open as well, but we're going to go over that a little bit later in the video. Your capless fuel port is going to be right here. Again, it's got the chrome accent trim throughout. And this being a Ford, it does have the keyless entry system, which is always awesome. Blind spot monitor right there. Overall, I actually really like the exterior of this vehicle, and if you do too, again, this is the last year you can get this design. Let's take a closer look at the interior and warm up just a bit. Okay, so starting off over here on the left side, we're gonna have all the window controls for the vehicle. Above that, we're gonna have all the mirror controls, including your power fold mirrors, which makes parking in a tight spot just a little bit easier. Push it again and they automatically fold out. Your lock and unlock button, as well as your three seat memory. Right here is the power fold button for the rear seats, and this will actually open the lift gate in the back. Under that, you have the rotary dial selector for the exterior lighting of the vehicle. You got your fog light button right here, and then to the right of that, you have a dimmer switch for the instrument cluster. Under that, you have an electronic parking brake. Coming up to the instrument cluster, very standard Ford display. You got your tachometer on the left, speedometer on the right, and a very big LCD screen in the middle. If I remember correctly, I think this is the upgraded instrument cluster over traditional XLT models. So you do get a lot of information you can monitor with this display. Coming back to the steering wheel, leather wrapped, it is heated, and it has very mild bolsters at 10 and 2. Right over here, we have the control pad for the center LCD display. This also has the off-road mode, which is my personal favorite. It tells you the pitch and roll of the vehicle, as well as the degree your steering wheel is being turned. Very cool. Under that, we have your cruise control settings, as well as your gap adjustment for the adaptive cruise control, I believe. Over on this side, we have the physical hands-free buttons for the radio, so you don't have to take your hands off the steering wheel, which is nice. And then below that, you have your hands-free call buttons. Very nice storage tray up top above the LCD touchscreen display. Underneath that, if this will come in focus for you guys, we've got your hill descent control, traction control off, hazard light, lane keep assist button, and then your automatic start stop off button. It is on by default. Below that, we have a updated touchscreen display. Ford is really good about updating their touchscreens, and every generation is better than the last. This does have Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, as well as navigation on an XLT is pretty cool, although most people, I would imagine, would use their smartphones. Below that, we have the physical controls for the radio with your 1 through 6 presets, as well as your mute button, your equalizer button, back, play, pause, forward, and then screen off. Push it twice, it goes off. Push it once, it just goes to the time. Pretty cool. Change storage right here. Push button start. Underneath that, you have a little storage tray as well, which can fit business cards pretty perfectly. Coming down to the HVAC system, it is dual zone climate control with heated and ventilated seats for the front passengers. This typically is unheard of in an XLT or base trim, so very cool that the Ultimate Edition gives you those features. Right here we have a little storage compartment, as you can see. Push it forward, gives you access to a USB and USB Type-C port, as well as a wireless charger, and a little storage tray right there. Push it again, and it closes for you. Pen storage in the middle, as well as 2 cup holders right here. Rotary dial selector with manual plus and minus behind. I actually do not mind the rotary dial selector in vehicles like this. However, I prefer a different method when it comes to trucks. It does save a lot of room. And then below that, you have your drive mode / push button transfer case. We're in 2 high. You can go to 4 auto. And then rotate this dial, and you can actually rotate through the drive modes on the center LCD display. My personal favorite is the sport mode, so we'll go to that guy. There you go. Behind that, we have a really nice leather armrest that doubles as a center console. Open it up. You have 2 pen storage on each side, removable storage tray with change holder and business card holder as well. If you look closely down in here, I don't know if it's gonna come through on camera, but you do have a 12 volt outlet. And then you also have these little notches right here for file management if you have some of those. Put that guy back in. Here's a closer look at the leather seats in this XLT. Pretty cool. Right here we have a 12 volt outlet. This vehicle has 2 glove boxes. One is right here, you push this button and it pops open. Second one is gonna be right here, and it does have a shelf in there as well. Coming up top to the vanity, it is LED lit for the passenger as well as the driver. I don't know if it's gonna come through on camera, but they do give you a 3-door universal garage remote. Up top over here, you have some glasses storage. Then you have your LED dome map light buttons. And because this guy has the twin pane panoramic sunroof, all of your controls for the sunroof are gonna be right here in the middle. Then you have your standard auto dimming rear view mirror. So overall, pretty cool. The Ultimate Edition does give you some pretty awesome features in my opinion. And again, this being an XLT, it is pretty loaded. With that being said, let's take a look at the back seats and see how much legroom we have. So getting in the back is really easy with these running boards and the grab handle right here. This one was equipped with the captain's chairs for the rear passengers. Very nice. With the driver's seat situated where it would be if I was driving, I'd say I have a solid 10 inches to maybe a foot of legroom before my knees hit the front seat, which is absolutely awesome. I am 5'11 for reference. You do get storage in the form of pouches behind both driver and passenger seats. 2 cup holders right here for the rear passengers. Under that, we have the climate controls for the rear passengers, as well as a media hub that includes a USB-C and USB outlet. And then over here, you have 110 volt, 150 watt power outlet. These leather seats are very comfortable, and they do have some pretty big armrests for you. On the sides, you have your HVAC vents on both driver and passenger side, and then you have your grab handle with integrated hanger hook right here, and your LED dome map light. Now getting in the back is real easy with these captain's chairs pass through. This is a three-seater in the back. Not much room for me being 5'11". However, you do get two cup holders on the driver's side, a USB port, and then buttons right here to help fold down the front seats. On this side, you have one cup holder, one USB port, and another button right here to fold down the front seats. You can also do it manually by pulling these levers on either passenger or driver's side. Up top, you got your LED dome map light. Then you also have your HVAC vents, if you can see them right there. So captain's chairs up here give you a lot of room. Not really all that much room in the back, but they do make this vehicle in a extended version. I believe it's the EL is what they call it. So if you had that, you would get just a little bit more room. Let's take a look at the cargo space and see how much room we have. So like I said previously, the glass actually does open up on this. So to open the glass, you're gonna come to the right of the backup camera, push the button, it will unlock, and you'll pull this little plastic latch, giving you access to the top portion. These seats can be folded down. I'll go over that in a little bit, but there's the glass. To close it, you just push on the black clip, or lever, I should say, latch, and close it. To open the trunk, there's a couple ways to do it. You can do it from the button to the left of the steering wheel in there. You can do it with the key fob, or you can come up to it, push the button, and it will automatically open for you. Besides the floor mats right here, we do have a little bit of in-floor storage, as well as your vehicle jack right there. LED lights back here, 12 volt outlet right over there. And then right here, you can actually fold down all of these seats and fold them back up with the third row, it looks like, from this button right here. So this is the third row left side. Push that button and the seats will go down. With the seats down, you do have a little bit of storage right here as well as back here. To put the seat back up, we're gonna push the button. Well, that one's going down first. Automatically. Move this out of the way. Push the button again. And the entire third row folds up, which is pretty cool. Once you're done back here, come to the left side of the liftgate. Push this button. I don't know if you can see it. It will beep a couple times at you, and then it will automatically close. So, pretty cool. Let's take a quick look at the window sticker. So here's the window sticker for this guy. Again, it's a 2021 Expedition XLT 4x4, 3.5 liter EcoBoost V6, and a 10-speed automatic transmission. Your standard equipment's gonna be right here. Optional equipment is going to be right here. Most notably, this has equipment group 202A for $3,685. And some other miscellaneous charges right here. This vehicle does come with a base price of $56,460 with $8,335 in options. Total before discounts is $66,490, but you do get the ultimate discount of $1,155, bringing the total MSRP to $65,335. Right over here, we have the fuel economy ratings for this vehicle. This vehicle is rated at 17 miles per gallon city, 22 miles per gallon highway for a combined fuel economy rating of 19 miles per gallon. I want to give Spirit Ford a huge thank you and shout out for allowing me to come to their lot and do a video walkthrough of this vehicle. If you're interested in this vehicle specifically or any of the 2021 Expedition lineup, I will be leaving all the contact info in the description below. This is the last year you can get this design, so if you're interested, contact them quickly because Ford is starting to roll out the 2022s. Let Cheryl Yaros know that you saw the YouTube video and she will be more than happy to go over all the discounts, rebates, and incentives you qualify for. In the comment section below, let me know your favorite feature of this vehicle and why. If you enjoyed the video, please consider giving me a like and share. Check the affiliate links in the description below to help out the channel. And like always, thanks for watching and have a great day.